In this video, we're going to discuss solving formulas. So first of all, what's a formula? Now, a formula is simply an equation relating variables. So formula is simply an equation relating variables. Okay, so let's give some examples of some formulas that you may know. So have you ever seen this formula before? P is equal to 2L plus 2W. That's a formula that gives you the perimeter of a rectangle in terms of the length and the width. So the perimeter, remember, is the distance all the way around a rectangle that you'd have to walk. For example, if this was like your garden, and this was L and this was W, you'd have to walk L plus W plus another L, which is how you get 2L, plus another W, which is how you get 2W. So the perimeter represents how far you'd have to walk all the way around. So this is a formula that gives you the perimeter in terms of the length and the width. Another example of a formula would be the formula for the area of a circle. And that would be this. The area would be equal to pi times r squared. Now r is the radius of the circle. So if you had a circle and this was the radius, r, this formula would give you the overall area of the entire circle. Another formula, a formula that you may know or that you may have heard of but you don't have much experience working with is this formula. E, capital E, equals mc squared. Now this formula is a little trickier to discuss, but you may have heard that this is a formula that Einstein discovered in the early 20th century relating energy and mass. And C happens to stand for the speed of light. But for our purposes, at this stage, it's another formula you may have encountered. Okay, so in this video, we're gonna talk about how to take a formula and solve that formula for one of the variables in the formula. So for example, let's take this formula and let's solve it for W. Okay, let's write down what we're doing here. So let's go ahead and solve for W. And we've got the formula P equals 2L plus 2W. Now when somebody writes solve for W, what that means is isolate the W. So this is a very important skill when you're working in problems, well, problems in math, but also problems in physics and biology and chemistry. Often you have a situation where you want to try to get one of the variables by itself that hasn't yet already been isolated. Like for example, here the P is by itself, but you may have a problem where it's more convenient to have the W by itself. So how would you do that? Well, the key lies in thinking about what we talked about in a previous video. Think about this W as being a couple things have been done to this W. Somebody's multiplied by 2, and they've also added 2L. Now let me ask you, did somebody first take W and multiply by 2, or did they first add 2L? That is, did somebody first take W and multiply by 2 and then add 2L? Or did somebody first add 2L and then multiply by 2? Clearly the first, right? Clearly we have this situation, which means that somebody first multiplied W by 2 and then they added 2L. So in that case, what we've discussed before is that what you want to first do is you, well, you're basically trying to undo these operations. So here, the last thing somebody did was they added 2L. That was the last thing done. So the first thing you have to do is subtract 2L. So I come over here and say, okay, the last thing you did was add 2L. That means the first thing I have to do is take away 2L. So remember, we're trying to get the W by itself, and the way we do that is by reversing, that is, doing the operation, the inverse operations in reverse order. So by saying reverse order, if the last thing that was done was adding 2L, that means the first thing we have to do is subtract 2L. And the left-hand side now, I've got, let's see, it's going to be P minus 2L, and on the right-hand side, I have 2W. And now finally, I need to divide both sides by 2. And so I get my W by itself. So now I've got, let's see, P minus 2L divided by 2 is equal to W. And we often write that with the isolated variable on the left. That is W equals P minus 2L divided by 2. So at this stage, I've solved for W, I've isolated my W. Notice that I didn't find a value for W. That is, I didn't find, W to be equal to something like 3/4. All we meant when we said solve for W is isolate W in that formula. Okay, so let's try another one where we are solving for a y in the equation of a line. Okay, so let's say that we wanted to, we had the equation, well, let's say, okay, we're solving for y, and we have the equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. All right, so solve for y, that means, as I know, isolate this y. And I can see what's happened. Somebody multiplied the y by 3, and then they added 2x. So that means the first thing I have to do is subtract 2x from both sides like I did previously. So I'm left with on the left-hand side, 3y equals, and we're going to write this as negative 2x plus 6. So this is a special problem that we're going to make use of later because it turns out this is going to be the equation of a line. And notice how I'm writing the x first. And the reason is because when we go to graph the line, we're going to write the line in a special format where the x comes first and the number attached to the x, that is the coefficient, is going to have special meaning. So we're now going to divide both sides by 3. And let's see, at this stage on the right-hand side, well, I can see that I've got negative 2x plus 6 over 3. Now, isn't it true that a over c plus b over c, isn't that equal to a plus b over c? Now, I know that's true because that's how we add fractions together. If two fractions have the same denominator, I go ahead and I can add their numerators. Now, if you can go from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, then certainly you can go from the right-hand side to the left-hand side. Now, what does that mean? That means you can take a sum, see how it's a plus b over c, and you can split them up. You can write the a over c plus the b over c, which is what I've done over here. I split up the numerator, so it's now a over c plus b over c. And that's relevant because that's exactly what I have here. I have a sum. Do you see how it's negative 2x plus 6 over 3? I can split them up right there, and I can write this as y equals negative 2x over 3 plus 6 over 3. And so now I look at that and say, okay, this is the same thing as y equals negative 2 over 3 times x plus, well, 6 over 3, which I know is 2. All So at this stage, I've solved for my y, and just as importantly as we're going to see when we go to graph lines, we've written this in a very special form where I have a number multiplied by x plus some constant. And so both the negative 2/3 and the positive 2 are going to have a meaning when we go to graph this line in a later video. All right, and so that's how you solve an equation for a variable, or solve a formula for a variable.